Breakfast Club. Mm-hmm. So I'm, you know, trying to put one and one together here. Mm-hmm. You know, Nephew Tellaferro could use just something. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
Hey, you know what's going on? Young nigga shit. CMG shit, nigga, to the devil. We gonna dab out this shit.
Lord have mercy. Oh, Lord have mercy. Shit.
What they talking about? What's up with the club?
After Tellaferro, Mr. Tellaferro TV. Oh, Lord have mercy. Black Yosef just gave me $1,000. Oh, Lord have mercy.
We out here, man.
You know, we got to end this interview in our cunning way. Now, last time, I asked for some money. I ain't asking for no money this time. But
I don't give you none this time.
I got a different way I want to hear this.
Like
that? No. I got some.
Talk to him.
I want to salute you, homie, you know, for building your own thing and doing your own thing, creating your own platform, your own website.
I got one life to live out my dreams, and I'm giving this thing all I got. I interview celebrities. I talk sports. I represent the culture.
All right, now you're turning up on MrTellaferro.com, shawty. Yeah!
All right, Mr. Tellaferro, how's everybody doing out there? Y'all already know who I'm with. 223 is on the way this Friday.
What's popping?
My dog, Black Youngster.
Whole lot of gang shit.
What's going on, brother?
I've been getting a whole lot of money.
You're looking like more money.
Yeah. I'm feeling blessed.
Man, I done seen you throw so much damn money the last few nights in California. What's really going on?
You must have just see what I just did, the listening part.
I heard the listening part. I was actually trying to listen to the music. You know, I have a job to do to make sure I'm up to date on the music.
What you think about the music?
I like it. You know what? I'm going to tell you the truth. I think it's your best project since I Swear to God.
Okay.
You know what? I came in here the last time we did an interview, and I told you that I thought the last project you had dropped was aging well. And I didn't like how it aged, but I really like how I Swear to God aged, and I think this project has the potential to do that.
Yeah. The thing is, so much different shit on there. Like, with this one right here, what made it so special for me?
Uh-huh.
Like normally when I record and I push it out,
mm-hmm.
I might go in the studio 3-4 days,
uh-huh.
and rush to do some songs and record 15 songs and be like, all right, it's a mixtape.
Uh-huh. But this time.
But with the album, I took my time. Mm. I made love to it. So, I nutted in it. I fucked with Alcona.
Right here, man. This nigga right here. You know what I'm saying? But we 2 minutes into the interview, my nigga.
Yeah, I'm just saying. So this one right here, it was different for me because it was like, oh shit. I had to record hundreds of songs mm-hmm. to get these 14 songs.
You went low on the features, all right? We got French Montana, Travis,
yeah.
We got Lunch Money,
uh-huh.
Yachty, and we got Gotti, right? Yeah. With all the features. By the way, I do my research, unlike everybody else, and just ask your bullshit.
For sure.
Why so low on the features?
Nah, because you know to be honest, no disrespect to nobody on the songs. Uh-huh. Like the people I got on my album or whatever is people that I really deal with,
uh-huh.
I really mess with. But the thing behind, but with our cameras, like me and French, we tight. You know, my big bro. You know, God is my brother. You know what I'm saying? Like Travis is my bro. So it's like, basically, what I'm saying is, I don't really like features.
I got you.
So I just said 100 words to get to one word. Damn. But I don't like features. I don't like doing features and really like that.
Yeah.
But, so what I wanted to do was for this one right here. I was like, I'm gonna do a little different and just go on. You know what I'm saying? Go and try it out. But I just didn't want to try it out with people I don't just know too much about. I want to do it with somebody I knew, like
but
Travis Scott or somebody.
But sometimes there's money in that, though. The big-time feature, the Drake single to come with a project or something like that. There's so much in that right now. Why not just go ahead and say, you know what? I could use a big feature. Pop it off. Why not?
No, I'm saying like now I do features now. I just when I first came in, I got songs with plenty of people, but I just never put them out. I never just been the type of dude like I'm gonna do this cause such on.
Uh-huh.
I ain't never just been that type of dude. And then like right now I'm on my rapper shit. I'm trying to be a rapper.
I got you.
Get it? Yeah. I'm trying to be a rapper.
You so. Trying to be a lyrical guy. When you say rap, you mean lyrical.
Now I'm trying to just like really do music like and focus on it like nonstop. Like.
Cause you say you an entertainer. You always say you're gonna be the biggest entertainer in the world.
Basically what I'm saying is like I'm trying to participate.
I got you.
I'm trying not to be the dude to say, ah, fuck that nigga, I ain't doing this shit with this nigga. Uh-huh. Fuck him. You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
I ain't doing it. So I'm trying to participate with the game.
Uh-huh.
And then participating is just enjoying life and doing music with other artists and shit. So this one I'm willing to do.
I gotta get into the album specifically. But before I do that, I got to ask a little arrogant question. Now, last time we did an interview, right?
Yeah.
Now, 10 seconds before we went on camera, a lot of people don't know this. Youngster said straight up, nah, I know who you is, nigga. I see your shit. And then now I got to awkwardly go into this interview. We got a show, I think, 30 minutes out,
uh-huh.
right after that. And I was like, damn, that kind of blew out the chemistry. Did you know then that interview, out of all them interviews you did, maybe outside of Breakfast Club, was going to be one of the biggest? We did like a million views on that joint.
I can believe that.
Yeah.
I can believe that because the thing is, like, people you be having on your show be lame as hell. Yeah, like,
Wait, hold on. I'm laughing. Wait, what you mean, lame?
I'm saying you do good. You do great interviews. And you ask the right question.
Yeah.
And you had the right attitude. And you smile. You know what I'm saying? You try to keep it cool no matter what. And even if they slick trying to disrespect you, just being cocky, whatever.
I'm letting a nigga talk his shit though.
But they just be lying. They be lying. So it's like with me, I'm entertaining.
Yeah, I got it.
People want to see me.
I got it.
They love me.
The album, man. This album. Now, you had a huge single in Booty.
Yeah.
And to be honest, you didn't really have to come with too much else because you got such a huge strip club record. We in Atlanta. Obviously, you know what it's doing to the strip clubs. That thing had turned in mainstream now all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Did you know what you had with that?
Number five right now on radio.
Pop your shit. Number five
right
now.
Number five right now. Thank Jesus Christ. You know, ain't too many. I don't think nobody from South Memphis did it. Like that. South Memphis. Now, Memphis didn't have, you know, got him with number one several times.
But you about to do it differently because I feel like when with a record like Rack It Up, you know it's going to be big. It feels like your biggest records like Hip Hopper and Booty, these just kind of like the ones that you don't even look to be the main joints. They just kind of take off organically. Do you feel that way?
Nah, I knew it was a hit when I did
it. Booty was a hit.
Yeah, so I think like when I was in the studio recording, mm-hmm. like the hardest thing was ever for me to do is record Booty in front of 100 gangsters. Everybody in this joint like, man, that shit bullshit.
You ain't had none in the studio. You didn't have them everywhere at Cali. You ain't had them in the studio.
Nah, but the thing is, they were just like, man, this shit whack. They were discouraging me. I'm like, bro, get out of my, bro, y'all tripping. So I'm recording, just like, all right. So you know, you in the studio, you just vibe.
Yeah, yeah.
But everybody just like, man, they whack ass shit. They like, bro, don't do it. Yeah. It's slow, it's whack. You waste your time.
Yeah.
Like, bro, it's a hit. I said, bro, I don't want the beat to go 2-2. So they come with the thing. So I went and did it myself. And then we put the beat around it. And then I finished the whole song. And everybody still like, man, that shit whack as hell. I'm the only one that like this.
Yeah.
All right, now I said, like, this the hit.
Start to feel it.
Put that bitch out. Label blocked my album. Run my mixtape. The label blocked my mixtape. So I was like, damn, it's fucked up. So I tried to do the Buddha trend. Like, I think back then. But I'm innocent. I didn't get the like the look it needed to get. So they took my shit off every site. I don't know what the fuck was going on, but I ain't tripping. But they blocked it, John. It's my first time being blocked from some shit like, damn, what the fuck?
Do you think I'm innocent was too hard? Like when you cut it on, like you got to be in a real aggressive, literally a shoot your grandma. I know this wasn't on there, but I'm saying a shoot your grandma in the back hole move when you listening to I'm Innocent. Do you feel like it was too aggressive? Like you were trying to almost. It didn't feel like it was organic in a way when you listen to it over and over. Again, I swear to God, it's my favorite project from you all time. Do you feel like it was almost too aggressive and people didn't receive it the right way over time? Like, damn, do I got to always be in a gangster mood when I want to listen to Youngster?
Nah. See, the thing is, well, I'm innocent. Like, and the crazy thing about it took me, like, literally, like, I probably recorded this shit in, like, 2 days or a day and a half. So the thing is, like, and it still turned out great. To me, it was like the whole over booted the hit.
Mm.
So how can it be too aggressive? Or how could it be too gangster?
Outside of Booty though, everything was, I don't know. It was a little aggressive.
Now, I mean, I was like I said, anytime I do music, I try to do it like revolve around my life.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time, I was shit fighting cases.
Yeah.
Going through shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, oh, shit, I ain't do that. Speaking
of your case, I mean, fans want to know, do you have an update? I know there's, from what I've been told, a trial coming soon. Is there any update you have?
I'm fighting cases. I got cases. I can't talk about that. I know you ain't the police, so you ain't gonna ask me again.
I ain't the feds, but goddamn.
Yeah. So we can go to the next. What was that?
Next question. Yeah. Hey, we're gonna keep it moving.
I knew you want the police.
Memphis. Memphis is on. It feels like Memphis about to enter that Chicago.
901 M Town shit, bitch.
It feels like Memphis about to have that Chicago moment, right? Like that drill, that Chief Keef moment.
Yeah.
You got you doing it, your album coming out too. That thing finna shoot to probably number one.
Then you got
Gotti have huge record like Rack It Up.
Uh-huh.
Bag doing his thing. And now we got Block Boy. And you just got a lot of Memphis right now. Do you feel as if though Memphis is finally getting that look that it deserves?
Of course, I feel like Memphis then like Memphis grown.
Yeah,
and like it gonna continue to grow. Like this is why I try to go back to the hood and sign artists and stuff. I just signed my little bro Young Money.
Yeah, I know Young Money.
Yeah.
You don't broadcast when you in Memphis like that though. You just kind of organically go back. I feel like a lot of people don't even know. I just hear.
Nah, I beat her.
Yeah,
like everybody do it when like people. A lot of people do it, go to Memphis. I ride Memphis by myself. I don't need nobody with me or nothing.
Yeah.
Everybody knows, so I know everybody named Mama, and I know everybody Mama stay at.
Yeah.
So you're going to stay where you at, and you ain't going to do shit.
take my address off Google Maps right damn now. Block Boy JB, he's from Memphis. He has a huge record with Drake. A lot of people, I don't know why people do this, but a lot of people like, damn, Drake, it feels like you're copying the Memphis sound. I think he sampled a few of Project Padlines and the Look Alive joint that's lighting the streets up right now. Do you look at it as a problem? Because you're somebody who had a relationship. I think Drake reached out to you a long time ago and had you with him. Do you look at what Drake does as somebody who's just showing love to a city? Because I know some behind-the-scenes stuff, just showing love to a city. Or do you look at it as kind of culture vulture a little bit?
Nah, I looked at my Drake my homie.
Yeah.
Like, I miss a Drake on a whole nother behind cameras. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're my dogs. So the thing is, like, with Drake always supported Memphis. That man got a whole family that's in Memphis.
I don't think people know that, though.
Yeah, he got a whole family. Like, I know this man, whole family. Everybody is singular, individual. I know these people. Like, I don't know them by name, but I know, like, everybody know everybody family.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody know everybody stayed. So the thing is, like, Drake, he really part of it. I look at Drake like he's from Memphis in a way.
Yeah.
Like, he half Memphis and half Toronto. And you say, they say he's still in the court, like, coming still in the swag and leaving. What is it?
Yeah. You want me to talk about it?
I'm saying how he's still in something.
I didn't say this. This is not me. It's a thing out there that's saying that Drake, I think it's a couple Project Pat lines. And I think he was showing
love,
though.
They were
showing love. I mean, this is not me, but I'm saying. I think that was like saying, Dan, you come in, people feel as if, oh, you rap about Memphis a lot, you bring up Memphis in your music a lot, but it's like you never really come stay. I think outside of this wave,
Drake being Memphis more than a lot of these rap niggas.
I think the narrative, though, outside looking in for somebody who don't know.
As God, he'll tell you, Drake, he be in the city, he be in the town.
A lot of people don't know. You
without cameras.
You catch his daddy slipping on Bill Street, just chilling.
OG.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody gonna fuck with him.
Yeah, ain't nobody gonna rock with him.
Yeah, I might smack you play with that man there. That man from Memphis.
Man, I think I seen you and Bag on stage for the first time the other night. Performing,
for the first time?
Performing Gang Gang for the first time. For the first time I've ever seen. And I could be wrong about that.
Yeah.
What was that like? Was there any issue there? Because for the longest, people was like, dang, is Bag and Youngster going to ever perform this great record that was lighting up the club?
Gang Gang is great hit.
Gang Gang is a hit? I told you that 9 months ago. The joint 10 months ago.
Nah, this shit, we was in Canada. Mm-hmm. Gotta had a show, he brought both of us out or whatever. But I fuck with Bag. Bag is my nigga. I fuck with him. You know what I'm saying? Like it's just when he getting money.
Yeah.
You know, when you moving and shit, I brother see my mama. I brother see my kid. I brother see my
How often are you on the road a year? Like is it even pointless to have homes at this point? If you're a youngster, you on the road so much.
Nah, you gotta have home because you still got people that gotta live in your homes while you're home. So you still gotta have your family there, you gotta have a home for your people, you know.
Yeah.
So you gonna have them, you know what I'm saying?
Just tell me, Youngster, how filthy is the money right now? Like, how rich are you right now? Like, damn, I know. Just give me a perspective. Give a broke nigga like me some hope and dream. How rich are you right now?
I don't even know. It's for real.
You got an accountant?
I got an accountant.
Okay.
I'm just saying, I don't even know.
How many times you broke that money counting, Youngster? Come on now. You got to give me some. Put in perspective how rich you are.
All mine's break. I don't even like using the money counter because every time I get one, I put so much money in there, it always break. I got broke money counters.
How many cars you got? Give me. I just need to go. I need some motivation, Youngster.
I got like 11, 12 cars.
God damn, Youngster.
Yeah, that ain't including what I bought.
You can only drive one. You know that, right?
Ain't including what I bought for other people. It's just I got like 11, 12 cars.
Damn, Youngster. I mean, golly. Do you ever get concerned about if I'm not as popping as I am right now, on the downside? Because I know Gotti has said in the past he's had to have those conversations with you. Like, are you investing the money? But I know you. I've heard you actually doing some good things behind the scenes with the money. Are you at the point now where you can? Look, okay, damn, do I really need car number 13? Or is it the point where I still got to flex on these niggas? Just let them know I need some more jewelry, some more cars.
Lamborghini truck on the way.
Right here, man.
I already bought it. I'm just waiting on it.
Ain't you the first with that?
Yeah. Okay. I'm the first person. When they put them up for pre-order, I'm the first person to went in and catch them. Like, I was already waiting on it. They like pre-order. Caught the ass. I just wanted to do it. It was a dream come true for me. So I called them ASAP. Stuff. Me going to pre-order, I want to bought my ass. Right then and there.
Man.
So I was the first one to buy one. I might not be the first one to, I'm talking about like literally no flesh.
Nobody. Yeah.
Nah, it's real, I don't know about overseas. I'm just in America.
In America.
I was the first person to go buy a Lamborghini truck.
Damn, I'm just trying to figure out.
I'm just waiting on it.
How many cars you need? How much is a Lamborghini truck run for? It's rich nigga talk. I can't understand.
The crazy thing about it, they're going to be between two to three. Because it all depends on what features you want to add. And I just changed my mind about what I want to add to my joint. So what I'm going to add, what I added from the get-go, I want to change it now, so it gonna cost me some money. It might cost me another 30.
So is this like the album gift, or what are you gonna get yourself? What does Youngster do to celebrate for the album? Man, it's a congratulations, bro. I said that off camera. This is a huge accomplishment for you, though.
That's easy. You go, you sit down with your team, and you talk about all the old, the good times, and you know what I'm saying, bad times, and like putting the album out. It's huge. Some people don't even make it to do that.
Yeah.
Like them, God always taught me, like, bro, little bro, you know what I'm saying. You blessed. You putting the album out. You know what I'm saying. Like, it don't happen either. He said people put them out, but on every blue moon. You know what I'm saying. Some labels don't believe in their artists enough to say, all right, we finna put your album out. They just leave you on the shelf. You just be sitting there.
Where, speaking of Gotti, where is he at with you right now? Because you've always been vocal enough saying that Gotti has always been more of a mentor. Don't feel like you work for him. He's just somebody that always got be there to get you game if you need it. Where is he at with you right now? Again, he's on one of the records on the album 223 out this Friday. Mm-hmm. Where do you see Gotti at as an influence in your life right now? And as you start to age, do you start to think about, like, dang, I see big homie aging. I like what he's doing right now. He kind of has separated himself and put, I feel like he's moved from just the trap rapper age group or whatever now to kind of in that realm of, he got hit after hit, you know what I mean? He can go anywhere.
Facts.
So what do you see him at as you kind of age and get older and now have an album out?
I mean, the thing is, with big homie, he kind of like, dude give me so much game, it don't make no sense. Like, I probably like, literally, when I first signed, I used to talk to him every day. And when, like, we always talked about business, just ideas.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll never forget, they was calling me trying to do a few shows.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, at the time, I'm like, man, I'm cool. I don't want to take it. First half of taking me, I'm like, no, I don't want to do it. He for going Counter on tour. He like, you can come with me to Counter.
Yeah, I remember this.
Yeah, or you like, you can just do.
This is like right around heavy, bubbling, getting hot. Yeah.
So I'm like, man, you talking about going to Counter do some free shows?
Yeah.
I'm fresh out the hood. They already trying to pay me $5,000.
Yeah.
So I'm like, man, and I'm like, all right, fuck it. I said, bro, I don't even want to go to do shows. I'm gonna go to Counter with you, bro. And
yeah.
Bro, just teach me the game. Teach me something while we moving, bro.
And put in perspective, people, this is down in the DM. Indeed. So this is when Gotti heading out Canada and all out.
Not there. Before that.
This was before down in the DM.
Yeah, so we went to Canada. So I went over there with him or whatever. I had my own money and everything. He'll tell you. Like, I went over there with him. I mean, I ain't gonna lie, I just soaked everything in. Because he ain't had no time. You got these long roads, long streets. How you doing, friend?
Yeah.
what you found out today? What you know?
Do you think Gotti gets a... You know this and what I mean by this. Gotti's a very quiet guy. And you're the... Even Gotti in his heyday said, I'm not youngster. Youngster, he wild. Like, youngster. But Gotti used to pop that shit, too. Don't get me wrong. But do you think because he's chilled out so much, people don't know how bad he used to really... Not youngster level. He used to pop that shit, though. I was watching the old joint from Ridgecrest back in the day when he was out there back in fifth grade. That type guy.
Man, like, got it. I'm talking about Memphis?
Yeah.
Gotti probably like, man, Gotti come out there. I'm talking about one of the first ones coming out the gate on that gang shit. Straight gang. I never thought I'd ever see a day where he was calm like how he is now. Man, he might be so with the shit. I don't give a fuck who he is, how big, how small, how little, how wide. Man ain't gonna dish your ass back. He gonna dish it every time. But when he started growing, man, big as hell now, man, with Roc Nation.
I had to put some of that bullshit down.
Roc Nation.
Hov.
He talked to Jay-Z the other day.
Do you think is it official to say he's the biggest to ever come out of the city music?
Facts.
I mean, outside Elvis.
Facts.
Is that official? Because I've always thought that.
Facts.
Official.
My facts.
Sold out FedEx Forum last year, birthday bag.
Facts. And the thing is, what's so special about it, he don't announce guests or nothing like off the rip. He just comes straight, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, that's real.
Yeah, don't get me wrong, like Paul, Juicy, you know what I'm saying? I love what they done for Memphis. I love it, Ron.
We're not throwing any shots at anybody. This is more of a respect to Gotti type thing. Yeah.
Yeah, I love what they done, like, far as, like, how they came up and they had a real, real run.
Mm-hmm.
But on one thing I can say about Gotti, the difference is... Cause I love what Paul and Juice and them did. Like, I used to bump that shit all day, pack.
For sure.
But the difference from Gotti is, I don't think nobody out of Memphis made more successful artists than Gotti. Like, dude got a lineup. Like, if Gotti said, look, all right, look, I'm gonna go to Dubai for a couple years, bro. Get with y'all. We all rich.
Let's talk about this, you know, lineup, though. Hold on. Is the CMG tour coming? I know the man.
Other motherfucker CEO, I'm gonna go to Dubai for 2 years, bro.
Oh my goodness! This man is grabbing.
They hold on to your feet. Don't go nowhere.
Because they broke. The CMG tour, is it happening?
Yeah. What's
the order of the lineup? Blockbuy open. Who come on second? Who come on third? And who come on last? Gotti come on last.
I've been seeing Blockbuy move, bro. Later. Yeah, that'll be lit if they.
Is it in the works though? You know or not?
No, I just know he cool, bro. Big homie been fucking with him.
I think y'all could do that shit, though. I think y'all got enough to sell some big boy venues out.
You got me back and I mean, if we did a CMG tour, it'd be CMG. We don't need nobody.
Nobody. Not too many labels can do that, though. When you think about that, for real.
Nah, I take that back. QC, they can do it.
QC can do it.
They can do it.
TDE can do it.
Of course.
But it's not too many more outside of that.
We talking about down south. I'm just saying, like, down south.
Yeah, not too many.
TDE got plenty of shit going on.
Yeah, for sure.
Plenty of motherfuckers.
You rock with Kendrick music or no?
Yeah, I fuck with Kendrick.
See, a lot of people look at you and be like, "Youngsta be on the ignorant." He be on the ignorant music all the time because he do a lot of ignorant shit. I seen you fill up a hotel room with money the other day.
Uh-huh.
A lot of people will say that he don't have he won't listen to music as conscious as somebody like a Kendrick. He can't get with music like
shit. I bump Drake so much, bro.
Drake don't count. Drake's a feeling at this point. Like, he's a feeling, brother. I don't even consider him a real person at this point.
Nah, man.
He's a feeling. He's an emotion.
Drake bumping, man.
No, he bumping him. That's what
I'm saying.
Don't
put a hate on my nigga.
No, it ain't hate.
Don't be a big old hater.
I'm saying he's a feeling. God's plan don't even feel like a person. What? It almost feel like Jesus came down and rapped that song. That's how it feels right now. That's where he's at, I feel like.
Nah. Too hard.
The album, man. 2-2-3. What can we
expect? Kendrick hard, too. I bump Kendrick. Don't get me wrong. Then you got your own choice of music. There's certain shit I like Lady Gaga.
And this is my one.
Like, quit playing.
Hold on.
I like it.
It's over with for Lady Gaga, bro.
Nah, bro.
I know that's your favorite and all.
That's my favorite.
Hey, I got a question for you. Alexis Scott. Is it Alexis Scott in the record in Booty or not?
He the first person to ask the question.
God damn, I be the one bumping it because I seen Alexis Scott.
Give me my hand out.
Yeah.
They let me know you really, really watch and pay attention though.
Yeah.
It's crazy, bro. People always ask me like what they on the internet, but I never respond.
Yeah.
So for the whole world, I said, if I hit Alexis Scott, I'm a motherfucking rocket. I ain't say lick in the sky. I ain't say that.
They said you said lick in the sky, lit in the sky, like I heard all types of shit.
I said if I hit Alexis Scott, and Google ain't gonna have to come clean. They playing, man. Y'all, goddamn, man. Scrape my words up.
I seen a twerking to the joint the other day.
Booty.
What do you think about just the overall? This is a feel good record. Like, this is a damn near family reunion, ratchet family reunion joint. what do you think about just the overall reception of the record and how it's been able to move and how many people you've been able to touch? Strip club, come on. This the joint that get all the strippers. This make them work a little harder than what they were via Youngsta Insta Snap. I'm just saying, this makes them work a little harder. Yeah. What do you feel about this record overall?
I feel like my booty, it's crazy because, like, this shit crazy.
Lit, Youngsta.
I put it out so long ago, and for it to just sneak up on me like, oh.
And then you already had hip-hoppers for this. Hip-hoppers was huge. People don't know that hip-hoppers was huge here. And then booty?
Booty kind of, like, made me want to do stuff for ladies a lot. It kind of like, okay, female. Because the female, it's like, they show love. They ain't got no reason to hate you. See, the nigga, they going to look at y'all. Weak-ass nigga talking about some booty.
I don't know though, Youngsta. I feel like that you got the party set music. Like this one, I feel like back in the day, niggas used to like records like this, but niggas kind of don't want to get twerked on by the chicks no more.
But I feel like, don't get me wrong, the niggas, they support me.
Yeah.
They always in my show, but the women support me too. So I was like, at some point, I was like, damn, I got to make something for these girls.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I got to make something for these whores. I got to make something for these ladies. I got to make something for these thought boxes. If I take you on a date and I buy you a $5 chicken box and you eat it, and then I fuck you after, you're a thought box. Because he came in the chicken box.
Now the nigga just said what he gonna do on camera, and it's gonna be a thot that still roll with it for sure.
Yeah,
Youngsta.
KLC.
I gotta ask you this: your shows, things have changed. Like I used to see the gangsters at the show starting out in the first few rows.
Yeah.
Now it's straight chicks bum rushing the stage with booty.
I love how the ladies support me, bro.
Yeah.
Like you know, you know what I'm talking about, like no flaws. They are, you know, females. I really love ratchet, black. You know, pretty ugly.
You pretty ugly. Ugly pretty.
Yeah. But they always look like sexual chocolate.
Yeah. And now you at the point now where
really
the shows.
Style now.
The shows are predominantly chicks. When you play booty, I heard you say at first you had to. You want to come on stage with me?
Yeah.
But now they running.
Breaking the gate.
Man, I seen something so ratchet the other night.
I'm talking about my mama.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my mama, they breaking the gate. I'm talking about, thongs, officer, ooh.
What was that in Nashville you had? I seen a chick the other night. I don't know what she was doing. She had no booty. She had no ass.
That's what
makes you still gassed it up.
They were making it important, though. My bad for cutting you out.
No, it's all good.
But they were making it important. Because the thing is, like, no matter if you got a booty, booty don't mean you got to have a big booty. When I said shake that booty, kind of lay on a booty. Now, I still came in the first, like, skinny petite.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, people don't know I like skinny and petite. This is my side. I like big booty girls and shit, but I like skinny petite.
So,
no matter if she had a flat boot or not, it was the fact that she got a boot and she proud to shake it. Like, I made it for all the females. Like, they be feeling down. You know, they be scared to shake it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They be scared to twerk. Twerk them bones, girl. I like that.
This nigga right here.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Truck that fat. I like that. You know what I'm saying?
If a chick don't rub your feet, can she be with youngster at this point in life?
Hell nah.
Flat flip period.
Hell nah.
I have never listened to youngster music. When they listen to this album, they never heard Booty, they never heard hip hop. If you're telling them what's going to be the vibe of the album, what could you tell them right now?
I'll tell them it gonna come in. It gonna come in with like that feel of like just straight turn,
mm-hmm.
and it gonna ease on to some old like somebody I probably been had out. They gonna fit it, mm-hmm. but I kind of want to put them in a vibe like I with this whole album. It kind of described me. Like, I want to put them in a vibe like if you having money, they don't just because you got money don't mean you have to do something for someone.
Mm-hmm.
Just because you broke, they don't mean someone have to do something for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, so don't expect nothing from nobody. And like with this whole album, the reason I say that because like everything, like it's self motivation.
You felt like you had more fun making this one. It felt like it just felt so organic. You feel like you're having fun doing the interviews right now. Cause I know you ain't really sleeping a lot right now.
I ain't been sleeping 4 days. I've been throwing money 4 days straight.
It felt like you had more fun with this than the mixtapes.
Oh yeah. Hell yeah. Cause it's different. Like I say, like I put so much different. I come in with youngster, mm-hmm. then I switch it up. You know what I'm saying? With the growth youngster, then I come back, so hit him with some different shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's like you gonna get sad, happy, smile, mad. I'm still gonna make you want to shoot somebody, but I'm gonna make you want to go do the right thing and hold people's hands too.
But because I'm a good businessman, I know you know this gonna get to Memphis. Y'all got a show in Minglewood. Could you tell me what we gonna get from that show?
You coming?
If you y'all gonna send me down?
Man, come on, it's done.
All right, I'm gonna hold you to that now. Yeah, I thought done. About we could do like a little, if you got time, like a little short little documentary or something like that in the hood somewhere.
Shh, I don't know about that.
You don't know about that?
I don't wanna promise you.
Y'all gonna give me, you got me down to the show though. You got me down to the show.
We're gonna get you there.
All right, I say no more. Right, don't do it through Mims though, yeah. That nigga, he's some timers.
From time to time.
You know, he got a picture with Jay-Z now, so it's everything's different now.
Right, man, Rock Nation. Hey, shout out to Big Bro, man, whatever, Rock Nation.
I see you announced Boosie for that show, right? Who else you got?
I got Boosie. I got my boy Wildfan Lucha.
Mm-hmm.
I got my boy Jacquees. Hey, ladies!
Man, you can't sing like him. Cut it out, youngster. That shit dead. You need the auto-tune or something. Damn. Then you hear Wendy Williams say Beyonce need auto-tune. If she said Beyonce need it, you know you need auto-tune.
I got a few more people I'm going to bring out on this joint. It's going to be something special. It's going to be great, man. Iron Lee's concert.
That's at Minglewood, March.
March 9th.
March 9th. Get your tickets. Get
little
your tickets.
Now you know. Little nigga.
Now you know. Four? I got it. Now you know. Now you have to. You know.
Do that tour.
Get your Spanish out, bro.
This for my. Remember that time.
We gotta end this interview in our kind of way. Now last time, I asked for some money. I ain't asking for no money this time. But
I don't give you none this time.
I got a different way I want to hear this.
Like that?
No. I got some.
Talk to him.
I want to do some in the city with some kids this year around Christmas time.
Let's do it. We gonna where they little bad ass at. Let's do it.
You know they bad as hell.
They bad.
You know they bad as hell. But
I love the kids.
But I want to do something special around Christmas time. Can I have some sort of youngster input if you're still breaking the bank? By the way, I know you at least 40, 50 a show. I don't want to count your pocket.
Hey, man, look, we doing 45, 50 bands.
Album come out, so that's going out.
Three, four times
that's going
a weekend.
Up immediately.
Three, four times a weekend.
Oh, my goodness.
It's different. It's different.
My God, do I got you? Yes.
It's a done deal. As long as kids involved, as long as you ain't pull no fake ass cheering move.
I might come up with some fake ass kid like around income tax time.
Hey, come out with Memphis nigga now. Memphis nigga gonna come with Jack.
Come with some bullshit.
Hey man, when a Memphis nigga
bring
say,
all the kids,
Jack.
They claim income tax.
God damn it.
If a nigga, hold on, if a Memphis nigga say, hey Jack, just don't even listen to nothing he say. He flogged you.
You been tell your good ass.
He been tell your good ass line. Look serious hell in the face. All lies. Hey, this nigga a fool. Hey, the album. Hey, 223, the album. Black Youngster first, his debut album. Please go get it.
Go get
iTunes,
my shit.
Apple, all the streaming services. Thank you so much for
go
the
get
love,
my shit.
My brother.
Go get my shit.
Black Youngsters, MrTellerFerro.com.
CMG Heavy Count, bitch.